In this video, I'll show you how you can automatically generate AI voiceovers for the text that you have stored inside of Airtable using ElevenLabs, one of the best AI voice providers, and make.com. Stick around. Hi, this is Greg from Business Automated, and on this channel, we help you save time and money by automating your business workflows. If you are new here, consider subscribing to get the latest updates or even joining our channel to get a wide range of membership-only perks. Our Business Automated website contains a blog section, which all the articles are coming from our Airtable over here. And we thought it would be interesting to convert the content of those articles into a voiceover that we could possibly embed on our website or even use as podcast. So to do that, we decided to use ElevenLabs, which is one of the best AI platforms to generate voice with great quality of different voices. So let's set this up together very quickly. So first, you have to register for ElevenLabs. You can see the link in the description of this video. Inside, you will see different modules that you can test and explore, and you can test out different voices and see how they sound. And this way, you can select the voice that you will be using in the next step. Once you have that, the next step will be to go to your settings over here and create API keys. So once you go over here, this is the place when you create API keys, which we'll be using in the next step. Now let's move over to Airtable. So now we already have the article over here. The things that we need is a field for voice attachment and field for the link to that specific files that we'll be saving on our Google Drive. And now to trigger that, we'll be using make.com. So you can also find the link to make.com in the description of this video. And here, once you register, the first step will be to create a new scenario. We will start this scenario with a webhook. This will be custom webhook. We'll add new webhook here. All right, so let's copy this link over here. And the way we are going to use this link is we'll go back to Airtable and we'll create a new automation that will react to the action here being generate voiceover. And here inside of the automations, we already have automation set up that will be reacting to the changes of the action field. So here, this will only work if we have update image, but we'll now actually change it to is any of update image or generate voiceover. And you can see that we already have one action for update image. So what we are going to do is we're going to duplicate this and we'll change the action over here, edit the conditions, and we'll select generate voiceover. And here inside of the script, we'll edit the script over here and insert the new webhook. This webhook is sending the record ID to make, and you will actually be able to see that link to this in the description of the video. So let's just do a test over here. We just need to select one of them to be in the status generate voiceover. And now we have one sample here. And as we have run this test over here, you see that the structure of this webhook has been determined successfully. So we know now that this, what kind of data this is returning. You will see this in a second. So we can see our base over here. Once you add the right connection, we will select the blog post. And here you can see what kind of information will arrive from the webhook, which is the record ID. So now we can test it one more time. So let's do run once. Let's go back over here and let's test it one more time. And you can see that we have the article that we were looking at, and we also have the text of this specific article. You can see the whole content here. So because the content inside of that field is saved as Markdown, so you see we have all those signs over here and we also have link. What we will do, we just want to get rid of those Markdown marks so that we send a plain text to ElevenLabs. So what we will do is a little bit of a trick. If your text doesn't contain it, doesn't contain links like that or Markdown, you don't need to do that. So what we will do, we will take the content and we will convert it to HTML. And then the next step will be that we'll actually convert HTML into text. We'll use text parser and HTML to text. So here we will take the output of previous module. This is just to clean all those Markdown formatting and any sort of links inside. Let's test it one more time. And now we have clean text over here. All right, and the next step will be to add ElevenLabs module, and this is really simple right now. So we'll add ElevenLabs, we'll select the voice, let's say Alice. From the model selection, the model for the voice generation is the 11 multilingual version 2. You can also use the cheaper modules, Flash or Turbo, but this is basically the most advanced module. And now we will take the text from the previous step over here, and we can play with the settings, but we also don't have to. We can use the defaults. These are just fine. And the next step will be upload the file to our Google Drive. We'll just use the transit folder. And finally, we will save back the content to Airtable. We'll update the table blog post. We'll use the ID from the first step. And what we will change over here is action. We'll change the action to mark it as done. And then we will add two things. So the link to the voice file, we'll use the web view link over here. And then over here, we would use the web content link and then original file name. We have to do one more step because this link needs to be available publicly. So we will add one other module here, which will be get a share link. And we'll use the file ID from the previous step to any type of user, allow the role reader on that specific file. And we can still use the link from the previous one because this will not change, only the permissions will change. All right, let's save it and then let's run it once. And I will actually not be using the testing here. I'll just update the scenario over here and then try to generate it from here. So we are setting generate voiceover. You can see that the scenario is triggered. ElevenLabs is generating the file right now. All right, so this is finished. It's going to take a while. All right, so we have a file that we can play inside of Airtable, and we have a link to a file over here. All right, and let's do a test here in Airtable.
In today's content-driven world, providing audio versions of your articles, blog posts, or other written content...
It sounds not bad. We do also have a version on this on our Google Drive.
In today's content-driven world, providing... 1. Airtable setup. You maintain your text content in Airtable by selecting Generate VoiceOver.
Right. So now we could actually use this to embed this on our website. So we can see over here there is a link to the code that I was showing you in terms of using webhook. And you also see that you can try embedding this with an audio file. If this is a high volume website, you might not be preferably storing this on your Google Drive, but you could try. But you can also share this to other distributors like podcast host, or share it on your social media, or share this with your team. Yeah. So this was the whole scenario. I hope this will be useful for you guys. You can find all the descriptions and all the details in this blog post article that will be linked below. I wish you a fantastic day and good luck automating your business.